on, guys. Welcome back to another episode of The Extra Point. My name is Luca, and I'm joined by Nolan and Frank. It's Frank's debut today. Yes. So everyone clap it up. Yeah. This is a big
happy
moment.
To be here. Excited to talk some football.
Oh, yeah. So, we're going to kick this off. This segment's going to be all about football. We're pretty much going to just preview the week four matchups. So the first one's actually tonight, Thursday night football, two division rivals, Lions, Packers. Guys, you can pick that up, good.
Frank, we'll start with you.
Okay. So Lions, Packers. Packers getting Christian Watson, his debut tonight. And Aaron Jones is also playing tonight. Jair Alexander, though, not playing. Big loss for the Packers. Amon-Ra, he's going to have a better night because of that. But I still think the Packers win this game. It's going to be tight, division rivals. But I think the Packers edge it out. I'll say 28-26. Tight game.
That's a very tight game. So I'm going with the Lions, 24-10. But the reason I'm saying that is because they are coming off such a hot end of the year from last year.
They are.
And they're still looking like the team that they were at the end of last year. And with the Packers, Jordan Love still has he's done a good job, but I think he still has some ways to go. And just with how the Lions have been performing lately, I'm going to have to stick with the Lions.
All right. I'm going to agree with you. I think the Lions are going to win this game. I think this is your classic divisional game. It's Thursday night. It's a short week. Players are going to be a little tired. But the thing is, the Lions, they win the line of scrimmage. Dan Campbell says his team is going to be known for biting the other team's kneecaps off. This is a big rivalry game. They understand that. Jordan Love last week, he had a great second half, but he went behind 17-0 in the first half. You can't have that against the Lions. That team will put you away. So I'm taking the Lions. But now, we got to switch gears here real quick. We're going to go across the pond next week. It's going to be a 9:30 a.m. game, U.S. Eastern Time, between the Atlanta Falcons and the Jacksonville, England Jaguars. So guys, who do you think is going to win this matchup?
I'm going to go with the Jaguars. Even though they just came off of a bad loss versus the Texans last week, they're facing the Falcons. But I do have a score prediction, but it's not for me. I would like to shout out Benicio, who told me, he's from the future, he told me 33-23 Jaguars.
Wow. Ooh. That's a good prediction.
Wow. So both teams are actually coming off pretty bad losses. The Falcons got embarrassed in Detroit last week, and the Jaguars got beat by 20 at home by the Texans, who not a very good team. So now they both have to go to London to play. It's going to be a tight game again, but I think the Falcons are going to win this game. I think Bijan Robinson has that breakout game that we've been waiting for, and I think that they win on a game-winning field goal.
Wow.
Yep. Game-winning field goal.
That'd be great for the English fans.
23-21.
All right. I think the Jaguars are going to win this game. Only reason I say it is because the Jaguars are the only team in the past, I think, 5-6 years, every year they're playing a game in London. So they're used to doing that, they're used to the travel, they're used to practicing over there, they're used to like the way of life over there, and like eating food over there. But I think the Jaguars are just really upset after that last game. I think the Jaguars are a really good team, and I think they're gonna make a deep playoff run this year. I said that before the season even started. I think this is a massive just get back game for them. The Falcons are gonna be a little confused. Like, they're not used to that London travel. They're playing 9:30 a.m. our time, so it's gonna be like a weird for their body. So I think the Jaguars are gonna win this game, but the Falcons will definitely put up a fight. Shout out to Bears Walter Pix. He actually did really good research. Kyle Pitts, for whatever reason, does significantly better overseas than he does in the States. So just keep that noted. But the next game, it's definitely game of the week, because a lot of these games, I'm not gonna lie, they're not very good. But this one is gonna be a really good one. Another divisional matchup. Dolphins, Bills. The Dolphins are coming off scoring 70 points, the third most points scored in a game ever.
Was it second or third?
Third.
Oh.
And they're going against a division rival with the Bills, who started the season very poorly, but catch their stride last week against Washington. So guys, what do you think?
I'm going to stick with the Dolphins. Because, I mean, yeah, the Bills found their way, but at the same time, it's the Commanders. Come on now. They're nothing. They got Sam Howell at quarterback. And the Dolphins are just so dynamic. They got their offense is insane. Tua's finally shutting up the haters, and their defense is finally stepping up. So right there, I gotta say Dolphins. But I'm not going with as high of a scoring game as last week. I'm gonna go with 33-24.
Right. Yeah, I mean the Dolphins putting up 70 is absurd. Mm-hmm. They could have put up 73, which would have broken the record. But Mike McDaniel decided to do the right thing and not kick the field goal at the end. But They're going to an environment in Buffalo, one of the toughest environments to play in football. I think the Bills, they're coming off of two very good wins. Blowout win against the Raiders, blowout win against the Commanders. Two not so great teams, but they're still good wins. And I think the Bills, the Dolphins, they're going to be riding high after that 70 points. They're not going to be ready for this Bills game. I think the Bills win this game. It's going to be tight, though. It'll be high scoring. It'll be a shootout. I say 34-31, Buffalo. Tight game, again.
I agree. I think it's going to be a tight game. If this game was being played in November, December, it's snowing, it's cold, I would take the Bills. But it's still fairly nice over here. And the Dolphins key, every great player on their offense, speed. It's hard to teach speed, and it's very hard to defend speed. They're getting Jalen Waddle back this week as well. He wasn't even part of the 70-point score.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Which that's just mind-blowing, yeah, in my opinion. I think, again, it's going to be a really close game. I think this is the game where the Dolphins assert their dominance on the AFC East, and they say they're the best team. So I'm taking the Dolphins. It could be high scoring. I'll give it a 32-28 Dolphins. Now, another game, Sunday Night Football. Before the season, this looked like it was going to be a really good game. Now, we'll see what happens. We got the Kansas City Chiefs versus the New York Jets in New York in MetLife over here. Guys, I think I know what you're going to say, but I'm going to let you say it anyway.
I'm going with the Jets.
Whoa.
No.
No, you're not.
No, I'm not. Come on now. Let's be real. Let's be real. Taylor Swift's at the game. Travis Kelce's going to go off again. And the Jets just stink. Zach Wilson is not an NFL quarterback. I'm even going to argue he's not even an XFL quarterback.
Really?
That's an insult.
He's just a good-looking guy, and that's all he has to it. He cannot play football. He can pull the ladies, but he cannot pull an offense. So with that, I'm going 31-3 Chiefs.
Yeah, we expected Aaron Rodgers to be playing this game. That's why it was put on Sunday Night Football. But now here we are with Zach Wilson starting the game, which is not good. I'm a Jets fan. I know what's going to happen. The Chiefs will handle the Jets. I'll say 27-12. It won't be as big of a blowout as you say, but Chiefs will win. Taylor Swift in attendance again. Travis will show off for her.
The tickets went up $30. Like, the cheapest ticket went up $30. I was looking at the game, and then I saw Taylor Swift's going, so I'm like, okay, tickets definitely went up. I looked, $30 more. Now the cheapest ticket's like $100 for a Jets game.
T-Swift. That's it.
Yeah.
I wanted to see Patty Mahomes.
So you see him too. This game, Taylor Swift's there. She's not there. I really don't care. The Chiefs are really good at football. The Jets are really not good at football right now. It's really simple. Don't have to explain it really much. I think this is going to be the last game Zach Wilson starts after this. Ooh. I think it's going to be Trevor Siemian's season. And hopefully it's better. Who knows? But I'm taking the Chiefs here. Mr. Nolan, weird pick for your team. Here we go. Monday Night Football. Seattle Seahawks are going to play against your New York Football Giants. What do we think is going to happen?
Well, first off, I'm going to go with my prediction, and then I have some very big news.
Okay, go ahead.
Seahawks, easy. The Giants' offense has not been able to do anything without Saquon. Their defense has just been abysmal this year. And the Seahawks, their offense just keeps on getting better and better. Geno Smith is looking more and more like a real quarterback. So with that, I'm going with a lot of blowouts this week. I'm going 38-10 Seahawks. However, news time.
Oh, man.
I did this 2 years ago and it worked.
Okay.
I'm giving up on the Giants this year, and I'm becoming. We're pulling out the team generator.
Okay, let's see. You're lucky you can get the Jets. All
right. If I get the Jets, I'm actually gonna cry.
That is.
Oh.
Chicago Bears.
I got the Chicago Bears because that's so much better.
I think that might be a downgrade.
Justin Fields. Let's go.
Yeah. Sorry about that. That's probably a downgrade for the Giants. But this game, I think this is if we find out if the Giants, how they're going to be this year. Like, their two losses were bad, but they were the two good teams. The Cowboys and 49ers are arguably top three teams in the league. Seattle, bad defensive line going up against a bad offensive line. The Giants, I think it's going to come down to who has the better weapons, and I think Seattle has the better weapons. So I think the Seahawks win this game pretty handily. I don't think the Giants are it this year. They're not the team they were last year. I'll say 28-16. So Seattle gets it done.
I'm going to make a clean sweep. Seahawks win this game. The Giants, they looked a little bit better last week against the Niners, but it's just They just don't look good. Seahawks are going to win this game. Geno Smith, revenge game. He played for the Giants for a little bit. Replace Eli Manning when he's going to break the record for most consecutive starts. So it's a revenge game for him. That's going to conclude this segment. Stay tuned for more.
Welcome back to The Extra Point. We're a new episode here. We're talking probably now what is the biggest weekend of the fall. You want to know what that is on any college campus?
Homecoming.
You damn got it. That's what we're going to be talking about here on episode 2 of The Hawk's Nest. So homecoming, it's on Saturday. We got our own show we're doing, pregame show, 11 o'clock on Saturday. Rain or shine, either if it's not raining, be outside, you'll be able to see us live. If not, we'll be in the studio. You can find us on our Hawk TV YouTube website, as well as the screen, and then on WMCX 88.9. Make sure to pull up, listen, Hawk TV, WMCX collab for a homecoming pregame show, where we will also be talking a little bit about, or we're going to be talking about, a preview of Saturday's game. So we got a Monmouth. They got a second straight non-conference game. They're playing Lehigh. In case you don't know, it's Hawks versus Hawks. It's a Hawks battle. Sounds a lot of fun. Lehigh, 1-3. Monmouth, also 1-3. Kind of tail of two different teams. One that's more of a high-scoring offensive team, one that's more of a low-scoring defensive team. I want to hear your guys' takes.
Well, I think that this offense on Lehigh is just bad. Their quarterback has more interceptions thrown than touchdowns, and that's never something you want to see in the game of football. And on top of that, they still got blown out by teams like Villanova and Dartmouth, so you can score the ball.
I would disrespect Villanova. Villanova's a good team, bud.
But you know what Monmouth has? Two words, Jaden Sheridan. I think he's going to have the game of his life on homecoming and have a big game where he rushes for over 150 yards, probably scores two touchdowns, and Monmouth comes home with the win.
I just tell you, he had a game last year. He had 299 yards on 12 carries. Hates to tell you that, but I think, you know, he's still going to be a big, important guy. I think it's a chance for everyone to kind of get the morale up. So, Frank, what do you got, bud?
Yeah, I mean, Jaden Sheridan's going to have a big part in this game. He's only averaging 4 yards a carry from this year. Four yards per carry this year. He had 8.4 last year, so I think he's due for a big game. He's definitely a very talented running back. I think he has a great opportunity against this Lehigh team that has coming off a couple blowout losses. I think that he's going to be the X factor in this game, and if he can get through the defense of Lehigh, I think he'll be set up for a big day.
So I think, yeah, you look back, do kind of a reflection on the Lafayette game from a week ago. The big issue with that offense and Jaden Sheridan was both of their tackles got injured. They were on backup tackles, I think. And you could tell they were struggling. I think it really, one of them resulted in Jaden May having a fumble in there. And I think it just got him down early, never really got back in it. But this is a chance, I think, everybody to boost him out. I mean, Lehigh, not a great offense. Front seven, I talked about them last week. They kind of got beat up by the big physical Lafayette offensive line. I think it's a chance. Their biggest weakness is the run. They're a young team. It's a lot of underclassmen. And guess what? It's an experienced team. You got seniors, grad students all across the roster for Monmouth. And guess what? It's homecoming. You want to win as a senior on homecoming. I could tell you that. That's for a fact. They're going to come out there. They're going to have a different mentality. They don't want to lose. What do you guys got?
Oh, I totally agree. It's homecoming's the biggest game of the year. And like I said, this is Jaden Sheridan's time to shine as a potential NFL prospect. What better time to have a big game than homecoming?
Yeah, I mean, Monmouth, this is their homecoming, big game for everybody. A lot of people are going to be there. I think this is the team that you want to face. This Lehigh team is coming off a couple losses, and I think that Monmouth, you know, they've had some tight games. The Campbell game, their home opener 2 weeks ago, they had the lead at halftime. They lost in the second half. Then coming off the loss in Lafayette last week, I think they're hungry. They're ready to bounce back. I think this is the team to face, this Lehigh team that is struggling. Interesting fact about Lehigh. Their rushing game is really struggling. They've had 10 different players have a rushing attempt in the three games.
I mean, I think they averaged 2.9 yards a carry.
Which
I mean, don't get me wrong. They played some good defensive teams. You got to give those teams credit, Villanova and all them.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's something that if that front seven it's a chance for them to click. And I think this is very important. You're getting into now what would be CAA play the rest of the way. And at this point, if you're thinking this is a team that we talked about at the beginning of the year, as a potential playoff team, being one of those 24 teams to make the FCS playoffs. Problem is now you're 1-3. It's slipping away from you. It's going to be tough to get there, and I think this is important. I mean, I feel like they can come in and win. I got a score prediction 31-21. But just getting everything right, you got some tough teams you got to play in the CAA. You got to play William & Mary, who's a top five team in the FCS. And it's just about getting that, because at this point, your only chance to make playoffs is you somehow run the table and win the CAA. Because 7-4, I don't, with a loss now at Lafayette, I don't think it's going to do it. Last take from you guys.
Yeah, I'd have to agree. In college football, losing just a few games can really take you out of the equation. We see how, and with some of the bigger schools, if they just lose two games, then they have no chance at competing for a national title. So you can't let losses get to you early on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, Monmouth still has a chance to bounce back. They haven't even started conference play yet. They can run the table in the CAA. They've got some tough games coming up, but they can get started on a high note this weekend against a Lehigh team that is struggling.
So yeah, 31-21, any quick score picks?
I was thinking more like Monmouth 25, Lehigh 15.
I'll say like Monmouth 34, Lehigh 20. I think Monmouth catches them.
All right, we got a Monmouth clean sweep. And so that's going to do it today for this episode of Hawk's Nest on the Extra Point. Stay tuned for more, and make sure you pull out on Saturday. One second.